this is Ben from GoRod, bass player. You're watching LOD TV and you make the right choice. This is the most progressive song of the album, and Opus is one of the influences of Matthew, who's composing the album and the music, and some kind of mastodon inside too. So Matthew is the composer, and he didn't want to do the same album or the same song at every time. So every song he writes, he put some of his influences inside the song. On this song, it was clearly Mastodon and kind of Opus, yes. So this is really the progressive song of this album, is this one, sure. And for this album, I will say it's more percussive, more incisive in the structure. It will be more like a song like chorus and verse and chorus structure. It's GoRod song, but maybe more, you get a more progressive song, yeah. It's more easy to get into the song than usually. Yes, all the take was in the Matt studio, in Bud Record studio, and the mix and master was made with Daniel Bergstrand in Sweden. In fact, it was via internet, and so Matthew used to record and mix our album. So he knows when he's mixing, he don't want to have someone in his back just saying, I will hear this at this time. So we choose Bergstrand because we like what he's doing. So we were really self-confident with his job. So we let him work, and he did a great job. So that's cool. It should have been if we could get to Sweden just to get with him and to see a little bit. It didn't happen, so, but he did a really great job, so that's really cool. Mikwa, in fact, is at the beginning of the formation of the solar system, when the Earth was just a proto planet, and the other proto planet who hurt the Earth and became the Moon, it was called Aethwa, in fact. And all the lyrics about the album are about the divinities of the Moon all around the Earth. And so Julian, the singer, chose some of these divinities to speak about all the cult that was around these divinities. You got some of the divinities from the Egyptian area, from the Polynesian area, from the Nordic area, all around the world, and some of the story of these divinities. Julian always did some researches from every lyrics he wrote. The first album he was in, it was Perfect Absolution. He was on the Wishan civilization in the 10th century, when they come to Christianity. Then the Amok was about the Rosicrucian sect. And this one is on the Moon and the divinities that refer to the Moon. The foreign market is really important to us, because we start with the North American market for the two first album, and we have a lot of a big fan base over there. And yes, we play most of our tour, our European tour or American tour. It is something you have to plan before going there. The best thing to do is one cost, come back to France, and then the other cost another time, or just it's more easy because most of the big cities are on the coast in the US, and you can just split your tour, and it's more less expensive to do this than to do a world tour. Our new target is to get more people besides extreme metal, in fact. We put some clear singing into this. When I mean clear singing, it's still death metal, but you got notes on the voice, and it really brings some new stuff in the Goat's music. And it's not just vocoder like we used to do. And we really try to open the music to metal in general. This is still death metal for the roots of the music, but it really opens to new horizons, and we hope that new people will get into this music and appreciate it. Yeah, the album will be released in October on the 90s, and then we got a world tour in November with Beyond Creation, a European tour. So this is the first step, and for the next year we hope to go to the States and all over the world, and a French tour of course, yeah.